Good morning, everybody. Honorable Minister Shri K.T. Rama Rao Garu, Secretary Administrative Reforms Government of India, Mr. Srinivas, who also happens to be son of the soil, Director General IIPA, Mr. S.N. Tripathi, Mr. Jayesh, Mr. Rajput, senior officers from the government of Telangana, and also senior government functionaries representing different states and union territories of India. It is indeed a great delight and a pleasure to be here in a city which is, as the Honorable Minister was mentioning, known for its progressive approach. And rather, I would add to what he said by saying that this actually is a city of Hyderabad, which is the possible one of the most illustrious examples of tradition blended with modernity. And this is a land known of its people who have the leaning to hold on to their tradition, to sustain it, which is matched with an equal urge, an equally intense urge to also look ahead and move on. And that is why, as was being mentioned by the Honorable Minister, rightly so, it's been always ahead in experimenting with new innovations and the new technological facilities available to us. It's also a matter of delight, as was being mentioned by Mr. Srinivas, that this 24th National Conference is being held in Hyderabad. And I think just a few years back we held another one, so which also is an indication of the compatible milieu over here to hold such conferences, which possibly brings the likes of Srinivas again and again back to Hyderabad. In addition, I would also like to share with you that we have started an exercise of holding regional conferences across the country, because soon after Shri Narendra Modi took over as Prime Minister in the year 2014, one of his advice was whether we could move out of the national capital and also be amongst the people in different parts of the country. And now, looking back 7-8 years, I think that has paid rich dividends. We have been moving across the country by way of these regional conferences. We had one like this in starting from up north in Leh, then we were in Srinagar, then we were in Jammu, then we were in Nagpur, then we were in Mumbai, then we were in Shillong, we were in Lucknow. So it's been north, south, east, west, northeast. And that has not only created a different kind of comradeship and fellowship, but also enabled us to exchange our best practices. And as I was suggesting to the Honorable Minister while we were sitting over here, we have now also tried, and I have suggested that we could actually do the coupling of these states. For example, depending on the requirements. So depending upon the peculiar requirements of Telangana, we could also do some research and find out what is the common between Telangana and some other state of the country. And then we could together move forward and ask them to replicate each other's experience, also supplement each other's experience, and come out with a new model if possible. And now that we have also started the Good Governance Index, and Telangana's Janahit platform has been recognized as among the best functional redressal platforms, I think there is lot much also to learn from each other. The digital governance, which happens to be the theme of today's conference, I think came out in its best during the COVID times. And those of us who were actually quite status quoist or quite tied down in the past conditioning of minds also found that they had no option but to go digital. So COVID, which came as a curse or an adversity, also carried some of its virtues. And I compliment Srinivas and his team that they succeeded in converting an adversity into a virtue by extending this digital governance concept across the country. And I think the outcome of this, which is quite gratifying, which also vindicates us, is that all throughout the COVID, now this has been almost 2 years of the pandemic, at least in the Department of Personnel, and I'm sure it must be the case in the other ministries as well, the office work did not suffer even for a single day. And what I say next would rather amuse you. In fact, we were working more than in the non-COVID times, because our colleagues were working from home even on the holidays, on the weekends. It was no longer that 9-to-5 conditioning of mind. And that flexi time also brought out the best in them, their sense of commitment. In fact, one of the junior officers at the height of the pandemic last year told me, because I keep talking to them because that's how we learn from each other, he said the new dictum should be minimum attendance, maximum output. We were working with 50% attendance, that at one point of time it reduced to even 25%, but output did not only remain same, but on occasions it was more. So I think now that we have learned what we were made to learn during the pandemic, we could put it to right use or optimum use even in the post-pandemic times. Not necessarily that we will be virtual all the time, because then we'll forget to recognize each other without a screen. But we could actually make use of the healthy supplementation of the two modes that we have, whether it's hybrid or otherwise. And this flexi timing thing has also helped us in more ways than one. Otherwise, some of the functionaries had to take a casual leave to perform some household chores or some other obligation. Here they were not attending the office, working even during night. Sometimes I would wake up in the morning and find a letter having been mailed at 3 o'clock in the night. So that was the kind of approach that was witnessed. So I think this digital mode of life, which the credit goes to Prime Minister Modi, he's been pushing it right from the day he took over on the 26th of May 2014. He's been talking of digital India right from the ramparts of the Red Fort in his Independence Day address, which amounts to the declaration of the government's intent and priority. It's virtually become a way of life. And for a state like Telangana and a place like Hyderabad, which had already been known to be experimenting in various modes of digital options, I think this is again a matter of not only gratification but also a vindication about all those exercises, projects that they have carried and the Honorable Minister was sharing with us. I think now this has also gone digital. So the more you talk about it, the nature also starts responding. Now, as far as the efficiency of the Central Secretariat is concerned, we have also tried to reduce the journey time of the file. Earlier on, if it was about 7 to 8 levels, now our ultimate objective is to reduce it to just 3 levels. We've already reached 3 to 4. And I think that's not difficult if we make use of the online mode more optimally. And if I just cite the figures, over 27 lakh e-files are currently operational in the Central Secretariat in the Government of India. And physical files have been reduced to just about 10 lakh. Though we may not have gone absolutely paperless, but we have gone nearly paperless. And this motivation has gone across the ministries. For example, we have a hospital called Tata Memorial Center in Mumbai, which also falls in the domain of the Department of Atomic Energy, one of the hospitals which is not under the Ministry of Health. They went paperless, cashless, and also filmless. They moved one step further. That was 3 years back, just before the COVID. So even the X-ray film has been done away with. So when the patient moves from one desk to the other, one consultant to the other, he carries his eye card number or eye number as given by the computer. The doctor pushes that mouse and he gets the film on his computer. And as far as the cash is concerned, he carries the hospital card. When he makes a payment of 500, 1000, whatever, that card gets charged with that much of amount. If he goes for an investigation, the card is just swapped and the amount is charged. So he virtually doesn't carry anything with him except for the hospital card, which is linked with all these devices. Now, as far as the CP grams is concerned, for which I must compliment Telangana has done appreciably well, we have now stepped into linking it with the central CP gram of the Department of Administrative Reforms, headed by Mr. Srinivas. And that would be in keeping with Prime Minister's advice of one nation, one portal. So anybody sitting anywhere can lodge a grievance. You don't have to wait for the office hours or the office desk to open. You can use your mobile app. Even if they are the middle of the night, you get aggrieved by something, you can wake up and lodge a grievance. And it will get linked to the concerned departments across the country. Now we are also moving up to district level. We have done that for the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. We are in the process of doing that for Uttar Pradesh. And similarly, as was being mentioned by the Honorable Minister, when he was citing the Honorable Chief Minister, ultimately, what should be the final goal or final objective of good governance? To my mind, and I think to every right-thinking mind, would be to bring in ease of living in the life of a common citizen. If it does not, any amount of platitudes would not serve. And as far as ease of living is concerned, we have to make it more central, citizen-centric, citizen-oriented, and also with increased amount of transparency, increased amount of accountability, and increased emphasis on timelines, which we have actually evidently proved to be doing, at least in the clearness of our grievances, we have fixed a timeline. The award distribution, incidentally, I believe is going to happen after I finish speaking. I wish it had happened before so that I could congratulate them. But nevertheless, let me officially from this dais congratulate all the recipients, because that has generated a healthy competitiveness among the various states. And this process of having conferences in the different parts of the country has actually led to a situation where we are getting requests for hosting such conferences. I have also noted down what the Honorable Minister said. Yes, we are in a big way in the process of what the media popularly describes as unlocking of India's space sector. We have started also involving private players. We have centers already in place, as he was mentioning. We are in the process of opening up centers at other venues, other locations, and certainly Hyderabad would also be in the queue and waiting for that. Because the kind of infrastructure they have, the kind of startup culture which already exists in Hyderabad, we would like to use it for the enrichment of the promotion of space technology in the country. And therefore, I think I would carry back this suggestion and try to work on it as soon as possible in very near future. now that India is already trying to match the global benchmarks, and in a situation like this, Telangana is going to have a very major role to play. So I just request the state government also to be on board with us, and we shall be board on with you, so that we can ultimately achieve the objective of becoming global excellers. You in Telangana deserve this, and you must seek this, and we are there to stand by you and assist you. Thank you very much.